Hello, Watermark family. Last week, we started our Easter series called The Cross in Four Words, and we tackled the theme of freedom. For this week, we will tackle the theme of forgiveness. Many of us are familiar with the crushing feeling of guilt and fear that something we have done or repeatedly done has permanently ruined a relationship. But the scriptures reveal that if we are willing to turn from our sin, God has made it possible to forgive all our sins, however dreadful they are, and be restored to a relationship with God. The background of this forgiveness of sin is found in the account of the Day of Atonement, Yom Kippur, which is still a day of solemn reflection and fasting for the Jews. One Jewish woman explains, when the fast is over, the hope is that your prayers were answered and you were written in the book of life and it will be a good year. Not so with believers in Christ. We could count on more than simply hoping that God has heard our prayers and forgiven our sins. Jesus' death on the cross, perfectly figured in the ceremony described here, was the finality of the sufficient atoning sacrifice for our sins. Tomorrow we'll explore the symbolism. We take the broader view of the Day of Atonement. First, we note the previous breach of the priestly protocol of Nadab and Abihu when they died when they approached the Lord inappropriately. Aaron was stunned into silence by this swift expression of God's judgment and probably felt reluctant to resume his priestly duties. On the one hand, the Day of Atonement was certainly a day for appropriate fear. It highlighted God's unconditional holiness. The high priest could enter the Holy of Holies only once a year, and when he did, he had to bring blood sacrifices both for himself and his family, as well as for the entire nation. The incense burning on his censer was meant to obscure the view of the cover of the atonement seat. He was forbidden to look upon God. Every part of the ceremony signified a careful approach of the living God. The penalty of any misstep was death. But while the ceremony inspired fear, it was also an expression of grace. Despite their sin and unworthiness, this great God of Israel had made his dwelling in their midst and made provisions for approaching him. An important reason to read a book like Leviticus is to shape our view of God. Culture today encourages people to believe what they want to believe. Inevitably, people draw conclusions about God according to their own preference. But the truth is, however, that God is not who we want him to be, but who he has revealed himself to be in the scriptures. Our passage for this coming Sunday is found in Leviticus chapter 16. And I want to encourage you to read the passage beforehand before we see each other. Looking forward to seeing you all tomorrow as we worship the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the whole world. May God bless you.